Smartmatic in April. The company remains in the running for the repair of existing PCOS machines as well as the supply of new ones for the 2016 elections. Joining us in the studio is Smartmatic Chairman Lord Malloch-Brown. That's Mark Malloch-Brown, Lord to me, who was also former Deputy Secretary General of the United Nations and also part of Gordon Brown's cabinet at some point. Mark, thanks for joining us this morning.
Pleasure.
How would you describe the nature of your chairmanship of Smartmatic? Do you see yourself taking a very active role, an executive chairman, if you will?
Well, I'm very involved. I work out of their head offices in London. It's a company that I believe very profoundly in. I've devoted pretty much all of my career to working on the promotion of democracy in elections. I was an advisor here in the 1980s to Cory Aquino. And so for me, this is a wonderful company which is all about building trust and confidence and security in election results in many parts of the world which, you know, have managed to adopt democracy but have real difficulty in securing the vote in a way that citizens have confidence in the results.
All right, a columnist at a well-known newspaper has referred to Smartmatic as a formerly Venezuelan company that is now a UK company, apart from the fact that you're British. Is that a pretty accurate description?
It was never a Venezuelan company. It started in Florida. It was a reaction to this famous Hanging Chads case between Gore and Bush when a couple of young Latin Americans who happened to be Venezuelans said, gosh, we could do better than that, and developed the software and technologies that became Smartmatic. It's done elections in Venezuela. It does elections all over Latin America because Latin America is a region with a considerable similarity to the Philippines, a history of disrupted and thwarted elections in the past, and it's in Latin America that there's been the greatest adoption of these systems, precisely because people trust machines to count fairly and, you know, not to get into the sort of abuse that has happened with hand counting systems in Latin America in the past.
All right, Mark, you press a very hot button there when you say there's confidence in an automated system. In 2009, a New York Times editorial actually called the voting machine business broken. That's in their word. So much so that a 150-year-old U.S. company, Diebold, was allegedly involved in the rigging of the 2004 elections. Why would you want to be in an industry like this?
Well, look, you know, I worked here in the 1986 election when it took, you know, extraordinary sort of voter protection through civil society organizations to make sure that Filipinos' votes counted. And in fact, that election, there never was a final count because there'd been so much manipulation of the ballots. And for elections going long after that, this same 30-day plus period where lives were lost, there was a lot of skullduggery around counting. These are the problems with manual elections. Automated elections have every kind of digital audit and digital key to them to make sure they're secure. There's a full audit trail in the case of the Philippines, you know, something like 100 appeals since you've had electronic elections. And each one of those appeals, I'm talking 2008-09 onwards, you know, has proved that the electronic count was right. I think there is, in the Philippines, as there are in many places, people who've either lost or people who would prefer to go back to a system where there could be a degree of manipulation of the result. But, you know, all the voter surveys, and you know, I trust Veritas, who were very involved back in 1986 in making sure there was a fair vote then. Veritas have just done a survey which shows overwhelmingly ordinary Filipinos by a 75% plus margin, and the teachers who actually conduct the elections by an 85% plus margin prefer automation to manual because they have greater confidence in it.
All right, Mark's the Smartmatic website itself highlights the theme, and I quote, because transparency is key in electoral integrity. Now, here and abroad, Smartmatic has had its issues over transparency, credibility, and integrity. Under your stewardship, how do you expect to handle that in the court of public opinion?
Well, look, this is a company which has counted nearly 1.5 billion votes, worked on 3,000 plus elections of different kinds. It is the world leader in this industry. It has about 50% of the international election market. So, you know, it's a company which is in a very controversial business, because there's always a winner and a loser on election day, and the loser's always going to cry foul. So the way we protect against that, before I became chairman and now I am chairman, is to absolutely make sure that our systems are watertight, that they are transparent and open to civil society and to the political parties to check and audit the results, that there's a full paper trail, that every vote has a paper copy as well as an electronic copy, so it can be hand recounted if necessary. Only through that absolute commitment to those sorts of audit arrangements will we retain trust in what is admittedly a controversial business.
Wait, still stretching that idea on credibility and integrity, you did unequivocally point out here that Smartmatic has never been a Venezuelan company, but correct me if I'm wrong, the chairman that had preceded you was a Venezuelan.
Yeah, yeah.
And in fact, allegedly, Smartmatic had ties with the late former president of Venezuela, Hugo Chavez. How do you explain all of that?
Well, you know, I think the big word is allegedly. The former chairman, who is still CEO, so still very involved in the business, leads it, in fact, you know, was a resident of Florida when these systems were designed. The company has never been a Venezuelan company. Hugo Chavez has never had a single share in the company. And, you know, the fact that these allegations are thrown at it again goes to the fact that, you know, voting is one of the key things. The winners and losers of elections have huge amounts at stake, and they'll throw mud if they think it's going to kind of tip the thing their way. And therefore, for us, the issue is to retain the trust of the actual voter, the citizen. And I think we do, by all accounts, and the Veritas poll out in the last few days is just further confirmation of that. We succeed in doing that. And I think you probably know, I mean, COMELEC itself, the election body here, you know, its own standing and confidence in it has gone up dramatically since it adopted Smartmatic's automatic systems.
All right, Mark, let me play devil's advocate here, okay? The question on people's minds, why is Smartmatic even still here in the Philippines? After reports that it had violated provisions of the election automated law, number one, for example, that it was never supposed to be allowed to bid in the 2010 elections because it did not actually own the software. Dominion Voting Systems owned the software. Plus, the difficulty which Smartmatic had to put the COMELEC through just in order to access the source code, issues like that. Your thoughts? People say we should not be subjected to Smartmatic again this time around.
Well, look, I think that's competitors who say that. You know, the fact is, yes, part of our technology is licensed from Dominion, but you tell me a large technology company which isn't using, in part, licenses from other companies, and we have a license for the international use of that particular piece of the technology that we employ. But, you know, we are a manufacturing and technology R&D company. We have hundreds of people who are doing R&D and hundreds more involved in manufacture. These are our systems. And, you know, the fact is, we are proud of the way we've transformed election performance in the Philippines.
So, Mark, let me just to cut in there and ask you, the license issued by Dominion for you to use their proprietary software, that is a live license. It's an active license.
Yeah.
It has not been revoked.
No.
Okay.
No.
All right. Go ahead. Yeah.
No. So, listen, I mean, I think the point that one constantly comes back to is, you know, I knew this country when elections took weeks and when people didn't necessarily believe the result was an honest one. I stood out in 1986 outside the election headquarters watching the COMELEC vote then, when young Marcos loyalists came out and wept in front of the high altar of Basilan Church and said, you know, we were forced to miscount the vote. The Philippines has a history where this has happened. When the election of President Aquino The result didn't take weeks, lives were not lost, it took hours, and the result was credibly accepted by the country. And I think that transformation, where a political establishment that was used to the vote's just the beginning, not the end of the bargaining process as to who's president, has had difficulty accepting that this thing has been stripped away from them, that now it really is one man, one woman, one vote. And the Philippines should be very proud in that sense of having the most advanced election system in Asia.
All right, the COMELEC had earlier disqualified